of Healthy Nuggets, where we get healthy one nugget at a time. Today, this is my last video of 2019. Thank you guys so much for everybody who has subscribed to my channel and for being here with me on this amazing journey that I get to share just with you. So if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Not only hit that subscribe button, but tap that bell so you can be the first to know about my brand new videos. So I decided that for my last video, I really wanted it to be something special and intimate, something that I felt like is a really important topic. So you guys know that I love holistic health. I'm all about holistic health education and awareness. And something that I really grew in this past year a lot was healthy relationships. So I want to talk about healthy relationships and what does that really look like. And I feel like there's three really important components to healthy relationships. Number one, God. Number two, yourself. Number three, everybody else or other people. So number one, as we go into 2020, as we're going into a new year and you're spending those time reflecting and setting your goals, because you should have already checked out my last video where we talked about that. But it's a time of reflection. It's a time of looking back, seeing what you did, what you didn't do, how you felt about yourself, how you feel about those relationships that are around you, how you feel about your spirituality. So this is a great time of reflecting, and it's a great time to rejoice and to think about how you can become better. You're gonna hear me say that a lot. I'm a big, big believer in this life is all about becoming better. So God, spirituality, how is our relationship with God? How is our relationship with what we believe in and the spiritual things of life? That has played a huge role in my life and in my health and how I view the world and how I'm doing on a day-to-day basis. So I'm not here to preach to you per se. I'm not here to try to conform you to every little thing that I believe in. I am a Christian. I do believe in the Bible. I do believe in Jesus Christ. And I've seen that power in my own life. My life was changed by really taking my relationship with Jesus and being a disciple for Jesus seriously. So it's really about that relationship and having that relationship and understanding what you believe morals and values are and really trying to live it. There's so many of us that don't have a healthy relationship with God or on a spiritual note because we say something but then we don't live it. And that's like being fake, it's being a hypocrite, and nobody wants to be that. So what I have learned personally is that to have that healthy relationship spiritually, you really have to figure out what do I believe is right and wrong? What do I believe makes me a better person? And what do I believe in that's bigger than me? You know, and how can I live my life day to day to be in a healthy relationship with my spiritual father? So definitely explore that, you know, and that's something that you really have to dig deeper in inside of yourself and seek some amazing spiritual leaders. Pray about it, study, research, visit some different churches, read the Bible for yourself, you know. So that's number one. Number two, one of the most important relationships you can have is the relationship with yourself. That has been a big thing in my life as well. And I can honestly say in 2019, I have had one of the best relationships with myself than I've ever had in my life. I loved myself more this year than I've ever loved myself in my life. And you have, like, if I could encourage you other than, you know, really trying to have that relationship with God, one of the most important things you can do in this life is love yourself. And there's so many people who do not love themselves. They hate themselves. They are depressed. They're dealing with anxiety. They're dealing with depression. They hate their job. They hate their life. They hate their spouse. They hate their kids. They hate their body. They hate the sound of their voice. Like, it runs deep and it's a problem. And I have dealt with a lot of insecurities and not liking things about myself and not understanding who I was and all of that. And we have really got to take time to be okay with being by yourself and learn who you are and learn to love who you are and learn to enjoy being with yourself. Like, go on a date with yourself. Really learn to love you, because you're gonna be with you until the day that you die. You were the first person that was with you when you came out the womb. You'll be the last person with you at the very end. And unfortunately, you can't take anybody with you. Even if you believe in heaven and hell, you can't guarantee or predict every person that's gonna be with you if that's what you believe, but you will always be with yourself. So at the end of the day, you gotta know you, you gotta love you. You gotta believe that you are beautiful, that you are handsome, that you are smart, that you are powerful, that you can do anything that you want to do, that you are worthy, that you are strong, that you are creative, that your life matters, that you are more than enough, that you have purpose in this life. You have to speak life over yourself. You have to literally fake it till you make it. That is a true statement. So you have to encourage yourself. You have to love yourself. You have to start telling yourself positive things about yourself. Even if you don't feel it in that moment, the more that you say it, the more that you'll believe it, and the more you will see it come in your life. So if you don't take anything else away from this video, love yourself and develop a healthy relationship with yourself, because when you're not healthy with yourself, you can't be good for everybody else. You're pouring from an empty cup. So you gotta love yourself, if nothing else. Number three, healthy relationships with other people. This was another area that I really grew in 2019. So in having healthy relationships with other people, you gotta evaluate those. Number one, you gotta evaluate your relationship with God. You gotta evaluate your relationship with yourself. And then you gotta evaluate those relationships, like, am I a good friend? Because a lot of people just wanna point the finger at everybody else, but sometimes it's you. Sometimes you're the toxic person. Sometimes you're the problem. Sometimes you're the common denominator. So ask yourself, am I a good friend? Am I a positive person? Am I doing anything with my life? Do I encourage the people around my life? Ask yourself, what type of friend do you want and other people, and ask yourself, are you that friend? Are you giving out what you want from other people? Once you've evaluated that and you really begin to work on becoming a better person, you want to then evaluate those relationships in your life. Are they fruitful? Like, do they make me a better person? Are they adding to my life? One thing that I noticed is that I had people in my life that every time I talked to them, it was so draining. Like, it was so draining. Their number would come up on my phone and I would already be like, oh my God, like, I just don't even know if I can answer this. That's not good. You know, and people have different seasons in their life where they go through certain things and they might be weaker than you, but if somebody doesn't bring peace in your life, if someone always stresses you out, if they make you feel like a horrible person and don't push you to be a better person, you have to kind of ask yourself, why are they in your life? And even more so, so many of us have unhealthy, toxic relationships romantically. And I've been guilty of this myself. I've entertained some very toxic relationships in my life. And I have friends to this day who kind of know within themselves that they probably shouldn't be with this person and that this person really isn't adding to their life, but they continue to hold on and hang on and keep going. And now more and more time is passing in your life and you're not really going anywhere, especially with this person, and you're crying more than you're happy. And you have to ask yourself that. Do you have more horrible days with this person than you do good days? Like, what are they adding to your life? How are you guys making each other better? Any relationship, whether it's romantic, a friendship, a business relationship, you should be adding to each other. You should be coming together as a partnership, no matter what the relationship is. So if you're with someone and they're tearing you down instead of building you up, you might want to let them go in 2020, and you might want to start praying about having healthier relationships in your life and saying some affirmations. One affirmation I like to say and encourage other people to say is, I have healthy and stable relationships with others. I have healthy and stable relationships with others. I have fruitful relationships with others. You know, start saying that you're mentally and emotionally stable and that you want other people around you that are the same. So I hope this video has encouraged you to have healthier relationships in your life, because healthy relationships definitely play a part in our health holistically. So comment below, let me know some other ways that you have become better in your healthy relationships with God, yourself, other people. Drop some tips below, because this is a community of all learning and coming together and sharing. The more we share, the more we know, the more we know we can grow and we can do better. So thank you guys so much, and I will definitely see you in 2020, boo, because we're gonna keep posting every Monday right here on Healthy Nuggets. Share this video, like this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys so much. Happy New Year. Bye.